Earlier we managed to get 84%. I can do the first part in the least number of clicks. But sometimes you need 3 clicks in the first part. I know where I can hold. I know where I can release. Because that part I use all the time. That was so close. There's a good deco on this one. It's pretty easy to get consistent with the wave here. Try not to do clicks that do nothing. Also, you need 2 clicks there. You need at least 2 clicks on that part, that little segment there. Because if it's in 1 click, you would die. But I was losing my focus again, so. I mean, I really wish I could focus on this part. If I can let go and where I can't let go, but when it's very difficult, it's hard to focus. You must go into the block there. If you do it early, you wouldn't be dying at the block. I can do the wave in the least number of clicks it would take. Or if there were some frame perfects on higher refresh rates, this could have made even less clicks. I know where I can hold, now I'm getting more and more consistent. Sometimes I would die in some consistent response. Very inconsistent with one of the clicks in this level. So I try to do a little smaller clicks, but sometimes I don't know because you know I went too high or low somewhere in this segment. Oh my god, I was a bit late, but we were somehow able to do it. If I die there 6 times in a row, I'm just gonna leave. Let's stop the recording and start another one. So 3 out of 6. 4 times already. We didn't die at the wave 6 times in a row, that's good. I missed the orb there, really, and I stayed an upside down UFO there, which really sucks. Oh, geez, another thing that could have really distracted me. It's easy to get consistent with the wave, but you could die anywhere in the wave. It was in the third part. they don't quite get it in the least number of clicks like this. Or they sometimes don't quite get the clicks right. Zoink might have done this in one attempt already, but I've taken more than 60 attempts. But the previous stats have been lost. Really, I shouldn't be jumping there. I shouldn't be jumping there. So sometimes, because of a small amount of delay, either holding a little or dying before the hold can start. Two clicks. I still died because I was too close to dying in many parts. So it was way too close to dying in some parts. See, I held, but it was too late. So as a result, it just died right away. So 2 out of 3. Myself a lot sometimes when that happens. If you use a few more extra clicks, you can get more consistent with the way than I was. Actually, I jumped, but it was a little before I could press the orb there. So I'll try to just do it the normal way I do. You don't click immediately in the UFO. This is one of the rare. This is where I kept. But I left for a small amount of time and I was still able to get the orb somehow early. But that was a good wave consistency there. Oh my, that was good. Good, we passed it again. I didn't know what. I had to let go there, because I thought, oh, I must have been late there. If the wave gaps are very tight, it's very hard, especially if there's a lot of delay, like in my playing session. Try to minimize the amount of clicks that do nothing. Like, oh, that was close. Try to minimize the amount of close to their attempts. I might not have been able to press the orb early enough, or it might have been impossible. Now, I knew, right? few more clicks than usual. Sometimes I end the right at the beginning of the level. So I'm very inconsistent with the level. Sometimes I'm just very inconsistent with the level. Because I was going there in practice mode, there was no rule against that. Now I'm consistent with the green orb click, but I sometimes get too early and still die. If I ever died there in practice mode, it wouldn't do anything, unless there was one waste. Because I was holding so early, oh, that was very high, very close there. I don't know if you can actually have, you can't stay as a wave actually. Good. Oh no, no. I was so low there, and then I pressed the orb, but it died after that orb click. What? Why? Really? What? And I didn't jump in the wrong place again. I didn't get confused for a little longer. Or maybe there's actually another part where you could save a click. I don't like to do that because it makes me way less consistent. Don't miss the orbs at 30% into the level. I have to take another extra time. I know, some people can do this in way more clicks. But I don't like to use too many clicks. I remained a robot and couldn't jump. Why did I remain a robot? That's kind of strange. What? Oh, that was pretty low, but we were able to do it. Okay, let's finish this level. Hopefully I don't get confused. See, it couldn't jump again. So the problem is it wouldn't jump when it's supposed to. So the wave, it's just when I'm holding too long. So there's no secret way in this level, like most others. It's just the ending. Press the black orb at 32%. So early and die like that. Why? Oh my god, why? Do two clicks here. It's easy to get more consistent with this level. So it's a 6-star level. It is a 6-star, but I hope we can miss the orbs again. Good, I somehow held it just a little longer. Thank god. Focused. Although sometimes I just get a timing wrong and I don't notice for like half a second. I missed them a third time. Each time you miss the orbs, will result in a death. So 30% is the choke point for me. I would keep going at around 30%. I'm gonna hit myself more and more for each time, each extra time in a row that I miss the orb. Not for each extra time I die at the wave, nothing else, just each extra time I miss the orbs. But we'll start at 10 and it will increase by 5. If I don't even have a chance to hit the orbs, I'll just hit myself once for each wasted click. Right after the wave. That was terrible. So I passed the entire cube part, the first cube. Oh, that was pretty close. First click. First click in the wave for the frame 2. Dying there. Frame 2 dying there. Need to jump a bit later here. Why? What happened? Here hit it on basically the first frame. Now, I didn't miss the orbs this time. So that will start from like 3 times in a row. I think I'll make it 4 times because I want to be fair. Now, I was lucky not to miss the orbs, but I was unlucky enough to just die after the jump. I can't jump there. First click, I didn't hold long enough. I didn't hold for long enough here. I held for like half the amount of time I usually hold. Clicks got wasted at once because I couldn't jump. See, because I kept dying at 30, I have set a small rule where if I can't hit the orbs, I would hit myself every single time. Good. Why did I jump there? At least I didn't die right at 30% this time, because I was able to hit the orbs. It's very hard to get past 30% for me, because I die there most of the time whenever I miss the orbs, or I can't jump when I'm supposed to jump at 30%, which I'm going to move to again. See, because I didn't hold the robot for long enough. Not a very common mistake for me. Now I'm gonna try to focus here. It starts at this robot. This is where I would keep dying. So hard. I would sometimes hit myself super hard. Oh, see, that was very close. Thank God I was able to hold. I thought maybe I could have died there. Thank God I was able to hold. New best. Thank God for that. We got another best. Because I didn't realize he had. But you can actually get the coin and die at 36% into the level. I want to be safe here. That was terrible. I didn't hold long enough. And I didn't notice. I'm getting more and more consistent with my wave. I'm getting much more consistent now. Too hard now, and I'm starting to develop a mind block at this point. not really getting a mind block anywhere else in the level. It's just that around 30%. If I did pass 30%, now here I didn't actually miss all the orbs, but I just couldn't get the gray other one where I was supposed to get the other one. I didn't miss all the orbs, which is a good thing. So I will count it as just missing the last orb. That was close. Still died right at 36% just after getting the coin. I still died just after getting that coin because I couldn't click. Try not to get too high or too low on any of those sections or touch any of the slopes. So here I might miss the orbs again. No, I didn't actually miss the orb, I just pressed it right at the start, which resulted in me not jumping high enough to reach the end of the... See, I didn't see it, because I touched the orb, I didn't think that one was a waste, but really, why would I only hit that first orb so late on, so late into my jump? But if I did pass those orbs at 30%, I'd be fine. Oh wait, I went a bit low there. I'm trying to get in the middle here. Stay in the middle. I'm not just doing that. I'm just staying as close as I can to the middle. So don't jump there. Okay. Oh no, seriously? I was just clicking a bit late there. See, the part at 30 is the hardest. It's around 30%. It's only at around 30% that I just die all the time. See, because there's a bunch of transitions. Okay, I jumped very late there, but still, I couldn't make it. I still couldn't quite make it. That was really good wave consistency there. Really, that was one of my best. But it was only two clicks. Missed the orbs again. Now, I'm not very consistent with the orbs at 30%. So it's common for me to die anyway, and it was either by just not holding on enough at 29 and then dying at 30, like this. Now see, here I clicked a bit late, resulting in me missing the orb at the second one, but I was still able to hit the first one, so it's fine. But still, that's another death at 30%. I only appeared I clicked twice there. This makes it very hard to know exactly with 100% accuracy which clicks are waste. Wait, I jumped, but I was right next to a block. If I was consistent at the wave and at the UFO and the robot, I would either die at 30% or a bit later. If I passed those parts all in one run, without anything going wrong. Good. Another best of 38, but I'm gonna stop.